Welcome to Sculpture Studios. Over the years, we've created various pieces of art for film premieres and red carpet events, like the giant footprint for the Walking with Dinosaurs 3D movie, and the Triwizard Tournament Cup for Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Here we're working for a branding and live event company called Icon, and we've been contacted by Richard Dale and Chloe Chidasama to create something for the Angry Birds movie premiere. This is to go to Cannes in the south of France, and we'll need a couple of our team to fly out there to help set it up. The concept is a giant nest with a large egg on top that can house a human-sized Angry Bird character. The egg then needs to break down on cue so the character can bust its way out. To begin the project, we've been sent some concept visuals of how they see it looking, and confirmation from the different size options that we've been discussing. Aden's invited Chloe and Richard down to the studio to talk through the different ways this egg could either split apart or break down, and the way the sculpture can break down for transportation. As this is going to the south of France, both the egg and the nest will need to split into multiple sections so they're manageable for transport and for handling. As well as the egg and the nest, we'll be creating a giant pair of Angry Bird eyes, which will total to around 6 meters combined from left to right. These need to have metalwork installed in the back so they can hang above the red carpet platform. With this project being more than something purely visual, and needing to be something interactive as well that can break down on cue, we need to do all the working out here at the planning stage to make sure there are no constructional surprises later on. The best way to explain the project to both the clients and the viewers at home is to make a small maquette which will eventually scale up once the process and project has been approved.
Hi folks, got the maquette here. That's scale wise to the egg to the nest. All of this down here is going to be in fibreglass, and it's going to be split into three sections, and that's nice and firm. So when the bird smashes out of it, he can break it all down and he can walk onto the nest, so that'd be lovely and strong, and then step down onto the floor. And the back of it is going to be inside the actual curtain first of all. He steps up onto here, the angry bird, walks into the nest, makes himself comfortable, it gets slid out, and it looks great because all the paparazzi and all the press around the front, and he just smashes out of it the best he can, and maybe with assistance. And then he's got a very, very low threshold down here. So when he's stepping over with his great big birdie feet, there's not a great big step over threshold.
All these little pencil lines are going to be suggestions of the egg already breaking, so that even if it does crack to an extent, either broken in transit slightly or while we're setting up, it's not too big of an issue because people can understand that's the nature of the project. And that's going to be the eyes on the backdrop behind, set up on the rigging. Blocking out the egg at almost 3 meters high, the build process starts with large billets of polystyrene. Using a hot wire to cut the bulk of the large shapes, the egg's then honed down using nail and wire brushes, saws, sandpapers, and then we sit on the egg to keep it nice and warm until it hatches. To save carving and then creating a mould of the entire egg, we're only going to be making one exact half, so that once the mould is taken and the two casts are made, they match up perfectly back to back. This saves not only on the polystyrene cost of not needing to carve the other half of the egg, but also on the other half of the mould cost as well. With more spherical shapes like this, naturally you have a lot of waste material, and here you can see the split lines where we join the polystyrene with our PU foam, and where the corners of the blocks have all been cut off. We always try to utilise as much of the polystyrene as possible in our studio, so the larger pieces we cut, we keep hold of to use in later projects, and the waste material we try and keep nice and clean for recycling. Starting on the nest now, here in the centre where the egg's going to sit, we're going to be creating a flat circular platform, and the nest detail will be carved around it down to the floor.
Up here, I'm working until I think it's 1:30 in the morning now. Everyone's gone home at 6 o'clock, so I've got a good chance to start on this. I've got about 5 or 6 hours before the workers come back tomorrow, and then we can sand it down and foil it and start to do our fibreglass process. But for now, I've just got to block it in and then carve it back with these great big nail brushes. It's going to take me about 4 or 5 hours to do, so I'll get cracking in this one. giant Thursday. Okay, it's about 4:30 in the morning now. Spent about 5 hours just carving this area. Tomorrow we'll lift it up into trestles and we'll go around and fine comb it. And then we'll sand it down and then we'll foil the whole lot. It's worth coming in of an evening or early morning. So it's working well. It's been hard work. My arm's hurting and I've got blisters on my hands. So sometimes I work hard. But looking good so far.
Here we're starting on the giant angry bird eyes. As both of these eyes are different from one another, being a left and a right, we need to carve both of these individually. To create something this large, what we normally do is draw grids on the polystyrene and grids on the floor, and we scale up accordingly. We're not going to be creating a mould for these, as it's quite unnecessary to go through the process of creating two individual, large and expensive moulds for just one cast of each eye. Considering we can work up a good finish on these once they've had the fibreglass added, and the fact that polystyrene in the back lends itself to being easier to install metalwork, we're just going to be giving these a blanket coat of glass fibre to make them nice and durable, and a flow coat resin to make it smoother. The nest's having the same... It's having the same application, with a sticky back adhesive foil layer first to protect the foam from the resin, going over with glass fibre, and a flow coat of resin over the top. We're adding different colour pigments to the resin for this job, both so that we know what layer of resin and glass we're currently working on, and it provides a nice base layer of colour before we start the artwork. This is the fibreglass mould for half of the egg, and we're proceeding to remove the polystyrene from the inside. Once again, a lot of waste, and it's always a lot of tidying up when working with polystyrene. The mould looks cracking, Aden.
Yeah, very good. Right, what we've got here is half the egg. This is that's the top, that's the bottom. Get slightly more tapered towards the top. And the whole intention is to go in here with a two-part foam, an A and B mix. We've sanded it down, and we're going to put a release agent in here, which is a really kind of high oil based. Now, we've done a test in this area here. We've done the test on there like so. We've pulled it off just to do a test sample. That's what we call a biscuit foam. On the inside's a bit lumpy, but that doesn't matter. I think it's more that real nice feel to the inside of the egg. But the main thing that we were looking for is to get that nice crispness going. And so when they break it, it does a nice crunch and it falls to pieces.
It's basically finding a compromise of something that's strong enough or rigid enough to last in transit, bearing in mind it's got to go all the way to south of France, to Cannes, strong enough to hold its form once it's out of the mould and put up in location, but it needs to be weak enough or brittle enough in places so that it can be smashed first time, the only time, isn't it? Only time when the egg's out on show and it's smashed with the big, large mallets.
And we're also making sure if a big lump does fall, it's not too heavy and it hurts the guy. So it's nice and light as well, but still got that rigidity, you know, to the whole thing. So that's good. Now, because this is going to be the outside of the egg, we're going to put the whole thing together and we will have a seam line running all the way along here. So we're going to cover it with a very thin render of plaster. And because it's quite nice in Cannes and sunny, and we can just sand that back or leave little cracks in there. And we can also add a slight colour to this to give it a more kind of an eggy feel to the whole thing as well. And we can airbrush some little cracks up it to give it that real sort of character to it as well.
What's the word, Aden? How's it going to look?
It's shell on the outside and organic on the inside.
Organic.
Organic's the word, yeah. And I think that looks quite eggy and yolky colour anyway. Quite naturally with all these little bits. So, But the only trouble with adding plaster to the outside is we're also adding a bit of weight. So hopefully we're going to keep that down to a minimum if we can. So one hit wonder, really got to work on the day.
With any R&D, there's got to be room for error, and this was definitely a bad batch, with too much oil in the release agent, we think, so scrap that! We're testing out different agents that work best with the foam, so that the whole shell can pop out in one go, with no sticking or catching to the interior of the mould.
We've got out two sections so far, in a PU foam, expanded polystyrene, and this is called a froth pack, and this is where we could just spray it into the mould.
We went through quite a few samples of the foam to work out which was the best material to use, both strength and thickness wise, and ease of application. We don't want something that took 4 hours to go off, whereas this goes off in about half a minute or so.
Well, there's loads of problems. Apart from the actual surface, we ended up with a lot of pitting, and other pits weren't really quite shell-like and too brittle. As I said, we went through about 8 to 10 with different types of foam, and this, I think, is so far the lightest and the most sort of biscuit without damaging someone in terms of the health and safety aspect. Now this actual egg is about 3 inches thick, so we can weaken it in places, so when they come to break, we're breaking it on the day, it can fall about comfortably.
It's got some natural break lines.
Yeah, so far it feels quite good, and it come out of the mould, which was our main objective, so good. Right, we've just been up to see the clients, we had a meeting, and the main thing was this collapses on cue at the right place. So what we've done is pre-cut the back of the side, and it's in a V shape, and you can see here we've come through in a couple of sections, but we can squirty foam that and then give it a blanket coat of very thin plaster. But the real test to see if this actually works, so I'm going to just smash it now in front of you.
And this is a regular mallet as well.
That's a small one. And we can pre-cut it a lot more than that on site, but that was just a real big floppy piece. But once it's the whole egg, then we can cut it more and almost go through to the surface.
That big bit's asking for it.
Yeah, I'll give it that. A change of heart here. We did have flanges on the inside, but that means us lifting the whole nest up of blocks and getting on the inside and doing it bolts. But now the idea is to have a flap that goes over the front with a screw, so we just pull the whole thing together and put a bolt through here, and then that enables us to keep it all on the floor and do it at ground level and then just pinch it tight.
Now the egg's been joined together, it's a lot more stable, and we're trying it out for the first time on the nest. To make sure the egg gets there in one piece and doesn't crack too soon, we're going to be transporting it inside the mould as a cradle, and the mould can also serve to create another half on site if any of the egg does get really damaged. We'll bring the foam froth pack along as well to make this cast. The doorway is cut out at the back so that Red, the angry bird, can get inside, and we keep hold of this doorway piece so they can reattach this back on when it gets to location. For the painting, we're starting with the 2K car body primer, and this is really hard wearing and durable for outdoor use. Gary then goes to work with the airbrush, building up in theatrical layers to give it a straw-like textured look. With the caster wheels added on the bottom, you can see how easy it is for just two people to manoeuvre, and we've tried to leave as little ground clearance as possible so the nest barely looks as though it's floating above the ground. Installing the metalwork into the back of the eyes now, we're experimenting with a couple of different handmade tools that we've made ourselves in the workshop to best bore out the holes for the scaffold bars, and here's Aden being an idiot.
Now, you see this tool here? We designed this ourselves, and it's simply amazing. It does the trick really, really well, and I'm so happy with it. See that? Gorgeous, isn't it?
Right. So, we're adding the scaffold bars into the back of the polystyrene, and we're bonding them inside with the PU expanding foam. Not only are the bars really deep inside the material already, but with so many scaffold bars added, this will be more than enough to support all the weight when it's up on the truss on site. As usual, everything needs to be sanded back and cleaned up to a good finish. We get rid of any large imperfections and add more fillers to sand back to give the paint a nice smooth surface to be applied onto. Once everything's complete and the transport's been arranged, we wrap everything up to put onto the lorry. Aden and Jess are now heading out to meet the sculpture in Cairns, in the land of blue, white and red.
Here we are in the Cairns for the Angry Birds Festival, and just before the launch, and let's hope it all goes well for the crew.
On site in the south of France, the event for the egg and the nest is being held at the end of a pier. It was windy, really windy, and things were getting blown overboard prior to the event, so Aden and Jess needed to be extra careful with the egg pieces so that they didn't get caught or broken by the wind. Aden's left the inside of the eggshell less pre-cut than he would have liked, but this is so that nothing broke before the event took place. This just meant it needed a bit of extra persuasion to break the egg, which Jess was more than happy to help out with. We'd like to thank Chloe Chudasama and Richard Dale from Icon for coming to us with the project. We always love taking on work for red carpet events, and this one was a really interesting job to be a part of. Please feel free to leave any comments below, as they're always appreciated, and hit the subscribe button for our latest videos. You can like Sculpture Studios on Facebook and follow @AdenHynes on Twitter, and for more of our work, visit sculpturestudios.co.uk. Thank you very much for watching.